Hi there, my name's Tony Gregorius, reporting for the Angling Times. Now I've come to Nottinghamshire today to Attenborough gravel pits. Now if you want wild fishing, this is the place to come. It's a massive water, covers a massive expanse of area, but it's got a lot of fish in it, but you've got to find them. Now one man that's been finding them lately is Rob Fryer. Now tell me a bit about the venue, Rob, please.
Well, it's a big gravel pit, it's been here for a long, long time. This is the what we call the second lagoon. First lagoon's on that side and the wind surf is at the back of me. Big shoals of bream, you know, but they're sometimes difficult to find, but when you do find them,
there's rewards there.
Proper big fish.
What do you mean by big, Rob?
Well, you want to go 8-9 pounds. I weighed 6 last week, 43.10.
Fantastic.
You can see the size of the fish.
So that's the rule rather than the exception?
Yeah, the proper fish, yeah.
Excellent, fantastic. What we're going to talk to you about now a little bit is even if you can't get to Attenborough, which we hope you can, is the tactics required for catching those big bream on waters that are really expansive. As Rob said, you've got to find the fish. So, first of all, it looks like we're on a feeder setup there, Rob.
Yeah.
Just talk us through it, everything, you know, like your rod, your reel, just talk us through the basic setup.
That's 13 foot rod. Normal average feeder on a clip method, we've got braid and a 8 pound shock leader,
yep.
Down to a 4 pound hook length and either a 14 or a 12 hook.
Sounds like a proper rig to me,
no
messing
about. You need proper tackle, or you just get smashed, because what happens is they'll come in nice and steady,
yep.
When they get to the net, they just go out, you know, they go mad. And there's been a lot of people broke on, you know, little hook lengths,
yep.
So you need proper gear.
So people have the misconception that bream will just, you hit them, they come in, but it's not the case here, is it, Rob?
No.
Like I say, they get under your rod tip and they'll go like carp. And you were mentioning the bites earlier to me, not little tips.
No, they're not little taps at all. It's like when you fish carp on the method and it goes from that to that,
yep.
That's how the bites are.
Excellent. And is that your experience with a lot of big bream waters like this? You tend to get wraparounds, yeah. Rather than little dinks and things,
yeah,
like that?
Yeah, because the wilder fish, you see,
yep.
They're not like... They're just big area, big fish,
yeah.
And you know.
And then the thing is with these fish, they've never seen tackle in their life before, really, because they're barely fish for at times. And so you can get away with it. And you set a size 12 hook,
yeah.
So a real proper. And what do you? What's your bait?
Bait. We normally put we fish dead maggots in the ground bait, casters in the ground bait. Not so much. We don't pour a lot of worm in, but pour a little bit in. We're using dynamite. Marine halibut green and dynamite bream ground bait mixed 50-50.
Yep.
We normally would put a big feeder on to start with, something like that.
Yep.
And put 10 to 12 of them in to start, you know, to get a better feed down, and then switch to probably a smaller feed like that one there.
Thanks.
And just keep, you know.
Fantastic. And your ground bait mix, how does that mix in with the bottom, Rob? I mean, is that something that stands out? Is it something that blends in? What sort of mix is it?
It does a bit of both, really. It'll stand out enough for the fish to find it and see it,
yep.
But it does blend in with the bottom as well.
So it doesn't, basically, you don't. What the last thing you want is a big shoal of bream to them. You don't want to get it suspicious, you don't want to get them, make them wary. The mix that Rob's using today is perfect. As you said, it stands out a little bit, but it won't make them cagey on the bottom. I was just looking, you were mentioning your feeders. Now, you actually make your own feeders, don't you, Rob?
Yep.
And tell me a bit about them. They look a bit different. What's looking at where the lead's positioned.
Yeah, the lead's positioned right on the bottom. We've got different size feeders. The leads are all, we can change the leads to different weights, different size feeders for different conditions. And these, with the lead on the bottom, will fly even through a wind that's, you know, straight in your face.
And will that help you hit the mark time after time?
Where you want to be fishing.
And how easy is that to change now? If you want to change that feeder, if you can just demonstrate for us, could you do that straight away?
Well, you can't do. You mean these are super glued in?
I mean, in terms of if you wanted to change
if you want to change your feeder on there, all I do is unclip that, take the clip off there, look.
Yep.
Pull that off. And that's it.
You're ready to go again.
Just clip another one on, clip your up length on. Away you go.
Look at that, that's 10-20 seconds and you're straight back in. And I guess that can help adding more bait, less bait.
Yeah, if you want to change your feeder to a bigger feeder or a smaller feeder, if it's a bit harder, it's done in seconds.
Fantastic. And just talking about location for big bream, coming away from the tactics, How do you go about, I mean, this is a massive expanse of water, how do you go about finding where those fish are?
Well, I mean, this is the ideal place. It's on a point.
Yeah.
You've got water going that way around that bend, water around that bend. Preferably you want the wind, wherever the wind's blowing.
Yeah.
Preferably a good strong wind in your face.
And that'll bring the fish into the swim.
That's where you want to be.
And did they give themselves away? I mean, have you seen a few fish jumping and things like that?
We've seen a few rolling this morning when we got early morning, because it's a bit flat corn, but normally you want to be where the wind is.
Fantastic. So that's a very simple rule of thumb, and the majority of the time it will work for you. As I said, the wind's been blowing in this way for a couple of days. Last week the wind was blowing a completely direction, the fish weren't sat in it in the numbers that they are at the moment. But at the minute, this is where they feel comfortable and this is where they're feeding. It's been a little bit tough today. I mean, we've still had a couple of bream, haven't we, Rob?
Yeah.
And, you know, but that's to be expected. You know, it's bright, it's clear, the water's clearing slightly, but, you know, the venue's still fishing well, and that's a great sign. And, you know, what sort of weights could you expect when this is in its pomp, so to speak? What weights have you done in the past?
You don't want... I've done 100 pounds three or four times on here, a couple of times in matches as well, but you don't want many fish for 100 pounds now.
Well, you want probably
15 fish, that's all.
Fantastic, yeah. As you're saying, if you want to get away from your commercials, like a lot of people, you want to try something different. This is perfect. It will test your skills a little bit more, but it'll make you a better angler at the same time. So there we have it. So if you're visiting the waters, you know, any bream water across the country, very similar to this, these are the tactics that'll work. If you want to come down to Attenborough, it's on a Nottingham Anglers Association ticket. Now that's £40 a year for the first year, but that includes your joining fee. And that's not just for this water, and that's for a lot of waters. It's fantastic value. If you think you're going to a commercial, £7-8 a day, you can come here and you get your money's worth. Absolutely fantastic. And if you're a match angler, you're running a few opens at the moment, aren't you?
Yeah, I've had a few matches, yeah. We've had four or five matches. The weather hasn't favoured us really, but we've still had weights £40, I mean, six fish for £40. You know.
And at some point or another, you think someone's going to do a big weight.
Oh, yeah. The conditions haven't been right for us really, but I think when the conditions are right, there'll be a big weight.
Fantastic. So, again, if you want to get in on those matches, Rob's number's coming up at the end of the film. You give him a call, get yourself booked in. So my name's Tony Gregorius, this is Rob Fryer, thanks for watching and we'll see you again next time.